So let me just ask you this straight up. Does that sound real, or does it sound like the plot of a Hollywood movie? We're talking about the highest levels of mathematics here, a place where people spend decades building up experience.
Well, guess what? It happened. In February of 2025, a 17-year-old named Hannah Cairo quietly uploaded a paper online that sent an absolute shockwave through the global math community.
And that reaction, that's really where this whole thing kicks off. To even begin to understand what she did, you have to understand how people reacted. And the reaction was just total, utter disbelief.
I mean, listen to this quote from Itamar Elavera. This is a mathematician who had spent the last 2 years of his life trying to prove that this very same idea was true. Can you imagine his surprise when a teenager he'd never even heard of proved that it was, in fact, false?
So who is this person? How could she see something that an entire generation of brilliant mathematicians just couldn't? Well, to get that, we have to understand the world that she came from.
Hannah grew up being homeschooled in Nassau, and by her own admission, it was a pretty small world. She talks about this feeling of inescapable sameness, of being really isolated from kids her own age.
And this is what makes her story so incredible. For Hannah, math wasn't some boring subject she had to learn. It was an escape. It was a whole other universe she could just slip into, a world with none of the physical boundaries she felt every day.
Okay, so how do you get from a self-taught education in the Bahamas to the very top of one of the world's most elite math departments? Well, as you can probably guess, her path was anything but normal.
Just look at this timeline. It is absolutely wild. She finishes calculus at 11. By 14, get this, she had taught herself the equivalent of an entire undergraduate math degree. And by 16, she wasn't applying to college, no, she was walking into graduate-level courses at Berkeley.
You know, a key person here was a mentor, Svetlana Stankova, who saw this unbelievable talent in her. And she gave her some pretty unusual advice. Just skip college. Forget the normal track and jump straight into the deep end with graduate courses.
And it was in one of those very courses that she stumbled onto it. The problem. The problem that would change her life and, as it turns out, a big corner of the math world forever.
The problem lives in a field called harmonic analysis. Now, don't let the name scare you off. It's basically just the mathematics of waves. It's all about how you can take any complex signal or function and break it down into a bunch of simple, clean waves.
Here's a great way to think about it. Imagine you're playing music in a really weirdly shaped room. For 40 years, this conjecture was like a law of physics for that room. It predicted that if the sound got super loud, those loud spots could only form in very specific, neat, predictable patterns.
So, how in the world did she crack it? Well, it started out as an optional extra credit homework problem, but she just kept going. She'd bring ideas to her professor, Ru Zhang Zhang, and he would gently tell her they were, quote, silly. But she never got discouraged. She just kept reading, kept thinking, until she built something totally new.
And that was the breakthrough. Her new function created loud spots in the room, but they were in this bizarre, jagged, fractal-like pattern, a pattern that the conjecture said was completely 100% impossible. She didn't prove the rule was right. She created one single, beautiful example that proved it was wrong.
Finding this one counterexample, it did so much more than just solve one problem. It was like she took the map of this whole area of math and just fundamentally redrew it.
Just let this number sink in for a second. 40. For 40 years, this was a huge open question. Mathematicians were born, they got their PhDs, they built entire careers, all while this problem just sat there, unsolved.
And you can just feel the weight of that time in this quote from Tony Carberry. For him, this wasn't some abstract thing. It was his favorite problem for his entire professional life. And then a 17-year-old just comes along and elegantly shows everyone why it was wrong the whole time. Just wow.
And the ripple effect was just incredible. Her work didn't just slam one door shut. It took down a few other related ideas with it. But, and this is the cool part, it also opened a brand new door. It gave mathematicians a whole new tool for testing other problems, a technique they're now calling Cairo-like constructions.
So what do you do next when you've already done work that's beyond graduate level? Well, she's skipping the whole high school and college thing entirely. This fall, she starts her PhD program at the University of Maryland. When she's done, that doctorate will be her very first degree. It's just mind-boggling.
Which kind of leaves us with this one last thought. For Hannah Cairo, mathematics was a world without the boundaries and limits of her daily life. So it almost seems fitting, doesn't it? That in that boundless world, she would be the one to finally solve a problem that for 40 years seemed to have no limits at all.